New Year's brings out all sorts of predictions, and on the eve of 2009, our next guest had this to say about commodities and the dollar.
I'd be buying these dips in commodities, buying some of these stocks abroad, and getting out of the dollar because it's a bottomless pit. When this dollar stops rallying, it's going to fall like a stone.
Not too bad. Since that's a prescient call, the dollar has fallen 10%. Gold, well, that's up some 50% or so. The always shy and reticent Peter Schiff of Euro Pacific Capital is actually back here on set with his top three predictions for 2010. Peter, it's a pleasure to see you in person.
Thanks for having me in.
Walk us through the top three here. U.S. economy will be in worse shape. What happens to foreign stocks? What happens to gold? What happens to the dollar?
Well, the U.S. economy is in terrible shape right now, and it's only going to get a lot worse. You know, Time magazine ran a headline a couple of weeks ago where they labeled the decade that just ended the decade from hell. They were wrong. That was a decade from sin. This is the decade from hell, because now we're going to have to pay for all those sins, right? Last decade is when we borrowed all this money, we printed all this money, when we had the housing bubble, we had all this reckless spending. We're going to have to pay for it. The problem is we're still committing the sins, right? We still have interest rates that are too low. We're going deeper into debt. We're not allowing the economy
Peter,
to go
through.
Peter, we're
shaped in what? In other words, you know, we've just had a great PMI number. We've had housing numbers that, in terms of the housing indices, that we're up off of. We're on multi-month highs. We're seeing labor. We're seeing
job
claims.
We're
maybe getting a positive print in December. It's all relative. But I mean, worse than what?
Housing prices are still too high. The only reason they're not falling, which would be a good thing, is because the government is artificially propping them up. You have 0% interest rates. You have tax credits. You've got the Federal Reserve buying up mortgage paper. You've got 96% of the mortgages being guaranteed by the federal government. That is not a good thing. This is a huge problem.
Well, it's a Band-Aid. I mean, and it's about a stimulus to extend this. I mean, housing, whether it's too expensive or not, you're seeing the economy recover.
No, you're not seeing the economy recover.
You are.
What we're doing is we're going deeper into debt and we're spending money, but beneath the surface the economy is not recovering, the economy is getting sicker. And that's why at the end of the year you're going to see unemployment higher than it is today, you're going to see interest rates higher than they are today, and you're going to see inflation higher than it is today.
At the end of the day, meaning by the end of 2010?
The end of the decade, yeah. The end of the year.
The end of the year, okay.
So if I had, so put those pieces together. If you see unemployment higher and the economy not doing well, where does the inflation comes from? The dollar being weaker, or where do you get the inflation?
Well, the inflation comes
from
the Fed. I mean, inflation comes from money supply growth, and the Fed creates inflation. That's what they're doing. But ultimately,
but if banks aren't lending money, there's no money in circulation. I mean, the velocity of money is not.
Sure, they are. They're lending it to the federal government. Who do you think's financing the national debt?
Well, it's the countries of the world that you've actually been talking about.
No, but a lot of it is being financed through our banking.
Banks aren't lending.
Federal
so, I mean, there's no inflation.
They're not lending to business. They're lending to government. The money is still getting into circulation. It's being spent into circulation through government. It's certainly going in through the financial
there's
markets.
There's no inflation anywhere.
There is inflation. Inflation is the expansion of the money supply. The money supply is growing rapidly.
Not until it's, it's inflationary.
No,
money is not moving around in a place where you have
It's already inflationary. You're looking at prices and saying, well, prices aren't rising. Prices should be falling. Inflation has prevented prices from falling, which is what we needed. But ultimately, you're going to see dramatic increases in prices. I mean, oil is up $2 today. Oil is at $81.50 a barrel.
It sounds like you're
Do you think
about
that could be happening without inflation?
Well, Peter, other than a cocoon, though, if I'm an investor sitting at home listening to you right now, I want to go into a cocoon. What do I do? Where do I invest? Do I keep putting money into my 401k? What am I supposed to do now at the beginning of 2010?
The same themes that I hit upon last year are going to work this year. I don't know if they're going to do as spectacularly well as they did in 2009, but you got to understand that the dollar is going to lose a lot of value, and the U.S. economy is in serious trouble because of what the federal government continues to do. The mistakes that the Fed is making,
Is there, though, Peter, any sort of discounting mechanism in the market? I mean, 1 year ago, we didn't know half of what we knew. We didn't know even some of the caveats, but those caveats are being well talked about on the airwaves by you, et cetera. We all know that we're going to have to pay the bill at the end of the day. Haven't we sort of accepted that fact in some fashion?
Not at all. All we've done is set ourselves up for a much worse economic fall than the one we had, because the Fed has created a currency crisis that's coming. It might even hit in 2010, but it might hit in 2011. But when the dollar collapses, and it's not just going to go down 10%, I'm talking 50, 60, 70% or more decline in the value of the dollar. And it's going to send prices ballistic in the United States for consumer goods. It's going to send interest rates into the stratosphere. And if people think the economy is bad now, imagine how much worse it is when all the unemployed people, when you can't even buy anything with your unemployment checks because prices are so high.
So, Pete, given your scenarios, which I don't disagree with entirely, but Is there a short in retailers at some point? Is that a name or an area we would get specifically short?
The worst place that you can invest money, if you're thinking about investing money, you don't want to be in any retailers in the United States. You don't want to be in the financials. You don't want to be in the areas of housing.
Across the board, there's not even one that you like.
No, no, because Americans are going to stop shopping. We're broke. We're done. Americans have to start saving. Unfortunately, they're not doing that yet because interest rates are still too low. Eventually, they're going to be a lot higher, and Americans are going to start saving. But that's what you have to understand. We've already spent too much money. The future for America is going to be in exports, at least for the immediate term. We got to start saving our money and producing so that we can sell products to people abroad who can actually afford to buy them.
So the export stocks are the place we should be, though, then. So you're playing into the coal, the steel, and all those types of things, and everybody who ships
them
as well.
If you're going to invest in U.S. stocks, that's exactly where you want to be. The problem that I see as an investor, and the main reason that I'm not playing it from the U.S. exporters, I'm specifically buying overseas companies that derive 100% of their earnings outside the United States. The big problem with trying to play the global recovery, and the global economy is probably going to boom in this coming decade, but if you try to play that from the U.S. perspective, I think you're paying too much for stocks. You can get much better valuations by investing abroad. But I'm also very afraid about the regulatory scheme and higher taxes that I see coming for U.S. corporations, especially U.S. corporations that manage to make money. I can see windfalls profit taxes coming not just on oil companies, but all sorts of exporters as politicians try to vilify the companies who are earning profits and try to seize those profits, for the common good.
Peter, gotta go. Always a pleasure. Thanks for the lively discussion, as always.